Good evening. I have been informed that Tanya will not be here this evening. She has something else going on. And so we need to remove that item, the world's best workforce achievement integration report, which she was scheduled to give. So I would move that we remove that from this evening's agenda, and with the understanding that we will deal with it at our December workshop.
Second.
Thank you. It has been moved and seconded that we amend the agenda to remove the item involving Tanya and consider it at our December workshop. Any further discussion, questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? All right. The agenda, now let's, we need a motion to approve the amended agenda.
So moved.
Moved by Dave, seconded by Kim. Been moved and seconded to approve the amended agenda. Any discussion, questions? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. So that brings us to the other item on the agenda. Ray Queener is going to tell us all about the strategic roadmap.
Good evening.
Thank you for being here this evening.
Thanks for having me. Did you have any opening that you wanted to say, Superintendent, first?
Thank you, Dr. Queener, Chair, Board members. Just excited that this has been quite the journey, and there will be a journey that we will continue as we continue to vision out our strategic plan. Is as we think about the direction that we're going and finding that North Star, it became very clear with the engagement that we started just about a year ago with the community, as well as some alum, and some of our students and staff, really what is a desired daily experience and what is it that we can better serve our students and our community. And I say, I believe you'll see that defined more clearly as we move forward. I just want to thank Dr. Queener in facilitating the work, as well as the team. That's inclusive of the central office all the way down to the school and our students in the community. So it's been a great process. This is a continuous improvement journey that we'll be on. So Dr. Queener, I appreciate you being here tonight to take us further into that journey. Thank you.
Our task this evening is to map out the strategic roadmap, and we're going to talk in detail about that. That's mission, vision, core values, and strategic directions, some of which are already existing for the school district. So it's a chance to revisit enhance, and then primarily I see most of our time spent on talking about vision. Before we dive into that, what we wanted to do is to give you an overview of the work accomplished to date. So if you recall, when I was here, the title of our process is called Classroom to Boardroom. And we've done the classroom portion, and we are back at the boardroom. And so we have some components that we lead the board through to wrap up the process. Biased, we think we've done great work and ready to present that to you and talk about it and then facilitate your conversation. So I'm going to, if you look on page 2 of your packet, that is our work sheet that we're gonna do. By the way, what you're seeing on page 2 is the extent of my graphic design abilities. And so once this is finalized, there is no copyright on any of this. You can format it and structure it in any way that fits Albert Lea area schools, and many districts do. I just don't have those skills. So the next several pages are actually supporting documents for that work. So I'm going to take you all the way to page 9. Starting on page 9, what you'll see is the work from the planning team to date. And what's the foundation of the work is the desired daily experiences, as what Ron described. So you see those statements for students, for families, and for staff. At our last session, one of the things that the team did was to begin to put some structure, and we call parallelism, around these statements. So you're gonna see in each of the groupings an environment category and an engagement category. And so we spent time looking for where are there similarities. And we don't necessarily always have to have an initiative for every desired daily experience, especially if we can accomplish the desired experiences with one initiative. So those are there. Hopefully you, most of the bulleted ones you should have seen before. And then we get to two theory of actions. The theory of actions, first you're looking at page 11, is the district theory of action. A theory of action, as we define it, is what do we have to, as adults, believe? What do we have to create? What do we have to provide? What do we have to value so that we can achieve the desired daily experiences? And so these are not meant to be initiative specific. That's coming later. These are meant to be a little bit higher level, but also serve as an evaluative instrument for the school district. So imagine as someone coming in from the outside, I may not know anything about what's happening in the schools, but I could take the district theory of action and start to look around and say, do I see evidence of all staff believing that students belong here? All students belong. And so we incorporate these into the everyday work of the school district. So the district theory of action is designed for all staff, all teachers, all support staff. And then we have a specific, on page 12, classroom theory of action that's focused just on the classrooms. So these are going to be more teaching and learning specific or classroom specific. But the same structure exists. So if I were to walk into a classroom or a principal walks into a classroom, are they able to see evidence of staff removing barriers to student learning? Questions on theories of action. So the desired daily experiences, that was the broad net that we developed some draft statements and then we cast a broad net and got feedback from 6-12 students, all families, all staff. And then the planning team stood back and said, okay, based on what our stakeholders said, here's what we think are the beliefs, behaviors, and actions that the adults need to take. They have not been reintroduced or re-engaged with the rest of the school district at this point. So it's the planning team's work so far.
But if I could add, Dr. Quinn, that we were guided to take the responses and not change the perspective or the language from those who are providing the input. So I think that we ensured that we brought that perspective and that value into what you're seeing here.
The planning team did brainstorm some ideas for how the district, schools, staff can engage with the theories of action. So the idea behind all of these documents is that they don't sit on a shelf. They're an active tool that are used to deliver on the strategic plan. Okay, the next several pages, pages 13 through 15, are the recommended district 3-year operational plan. So if you think about the desired daily experiences as kind of the high level that we're aiming for, the theories of actions are our behaviors, our beliefs. This is the actual work that's being proposed to deliver on the desired daily experiences. Not all the work necessarily drives at the desired daily experiences, because there are other components that you'll see in here, but by and large, that was our guide. So let me give you a bit of an orientation around the plan and a couple of caveats. On the left-hand side, you're gonna see the 5 strategic directions. Those strategic directions are board governance decision, a board governance decision. So what the team did is they have drafts for your consideration in the strategic roadmap. Those were generated out of looking to the 3 years, 23, 24 through 25, 26, at the work that's being proposed. You're gonna see 4 levels of work for each strategic direction. And I'm gonna start actually at the bottom. So if you find strategy A, and you go down to that fourth row in strategy A, you're gonna see standard work practices. Standard work practices is defined as those things that have been fully committed to, they've been being implemented, but they're not quite there. They're close, but not quite. And so anything in the standard work is pieces that the district's been working on, but just not quite fully implemented. Eventually, the standard work row will disappear from this table. And the reason being is that implementing this system, we don't let things come out of implementation until they're implemented. I don't know a lot about private sector, but I know in education, we are really good at starting initiatives, and we carry them a ways, but we have a hard time sometimes finishing them. And it's common in every place I've worked, it's common in districts that I'm working with. And so the system here is meant to prevent that, so we're not dragging initiatives for years that aren't fully implemented. As you move up in rows, you're gonna see 2 levels of implementation. Basically, the 2 rows are change readiness and change management. And a simple distinction is that in change readiness, an initiative is probably considered at the district level. So it might be in pilot, it might be first year implementation. There's a lot of district level support in terms of district people. Things that are in change management are handed off to principals and directors for implementation. So they're overseeing the implementation. Learning work is work, it's our R&D. What are we thinking about? What are we studying? What are we wondering about? And sometimes you will see items in learning work that are specific, and sometimes they're generic. So exploring evidence-based reading instruction, that's fairly narrow. You might see an item in learning work that says increasing parent engagement. We're not sure what that initiative looks like. We just know at the end of it, we want to figure out how we're going to increase parent engagement. So I know you're probably familiar with a curriculum adoption process. So if you think about how this works, when a curriculum committee comes together and they're looking at their scope and sequence, when they're thinking about their assessments, kind of all the structures, that would be learning work. That would be their first year. Near the end of that first year, they might be thinking about or looking for resources and materials. So that's all kind of that first-year curriculum process. Once there's a decision made on what curriculum to move forward with, that goes into implementation change readiness. So that first year of that implementation, there's a lot of support. We have a lot of professional development. We have support from the district level, teaching and learning folks primarily in the curriculum adoption. But after year one, it's handed off to the principals for change management. They're overseeing the implementation of that. And eventually, after a couple years, that becomes standard work. So that's the methodology of how the system works. So let me pause and see if there's any structure questions so far. To date or coming up? So once the board approves the roadmap, that then sets in place the vision. And again, assuming that this is all in alignment, that this doesn't change, then the next phase of this process is to develop an implementation plan, or we call it action cards, but an implementation plan. And that's where we're looking at detailed steps of what happens first, what happens second, and third. That will happen later this year. So right now, this is draft. This is our best work. If we come to the board and it won't happen, I don't think, here, but if a board takes a left turn and says, nope, we're going that way, then we'd have to come back and revisit this. So first we want to check for alignment, and then we come back and develop the implementation plan. So that's where they would become more involved, unless you're on a building leadership team. Then you might have a role in actually mapping out or developing the implementation work. So we asked the principal to invite one or two or three staff members to come to that session so that they're part of developing the plan. Answer your questions?
Well, yeah. In other words, it isn't, as of right now, individual teachers in their classrooms have no direction or no insight.
Yes, and there are pieces where they already know some of what's happening because it's been being implemented already. And they may know what MTSS Tier 1 is, but they don't know what the detailed plan is yet. Yes, they're still on that path. Nothing's changed that work yet. By and large, what you see in 23-24 doesn't significantly change the work to date. When we move to out years, that's when we first want to focus on getting things completed that we started. And then as we start to look at anything new or adding to the mix, then that happens in out years. And the other thing that I think it's important for teachers to know is that also part of this system is we ask every year what needs to leave. So this isn't just about adding to the plate, it's also saying what can we strategically take off. You don't have unlimited resources.
Last I checked, that would be no.
No. Right, so whether it's time or money, we have to constantly look at that. And that's, frankly, that's one of the harder things of this process, that's why budget cuts are so hard. Because everything you're doing is helping or benefiting someone, and when you take things away, you have to make a choice. Other structure or format questions so far? All right, then a couple of things about the operational plan. This is meant to be dynamic. Traditional strategic planning, we would be sitting here looking at a static plan. Here's our 5-year plan. This is what we're doing year one. This is meant to be dynamic, which means this could be updated quarterly as needed to respond to different conditions. it allows the fluidity of the operation to actually be responsive, as well as still provide a planning instrument. The last comment that I'll make about this before we dive into some of the detail is that the operational plan, we say, is a tool of management. So the superintendent and their team are putting this forth as their recommended work. Most of this is education focused. And so we put that forward for awareness for the board, because in order for the school board to act in governance on some of these issues, you have to be aware of what's happening or what's being proposed here. So the management and the governance have to operate in tandem. And so we review this tonight so that you have awareness and information before you get to the vision conversation. All right, so I thought what I would do now is go ahead and just read all the detailed lines to you for all 3 years. Just kidding. Little levity, right? No, I know that you've had a chance to take a look at this or glance at this before the meeting. And what we want to do, and all the easy questions I'll answer, all the hard questions Ron's got, we'll just kind of walk through the strategies one at a time and see if there's any questions about any of the initiatives that are being proposed, what does something mean, any clarity we can provide, and then we'll come back to the board work afterwards. So, strategy A, amplifying student learning, ensuring they are well prepared for classroom and career transitions. Any questions, wonderings, insights about anything you see in those four rows? Correct.
Are they strategies to help where we meet, where we test out weak?
No, not at all. These would be, as our best understanding, this is where we are. This could be some that are coming, that are already in place, that we need to refine or back up and redo. So it's not necessarily a weakness. I look at it as a growing edge and growing opportunities.
All right, so then strategy B is fostering a learning environment that prioritizes academic success, mental and emotional well-being, and inclusivity. And so you see some work that's either current initiatives or exploratory work in the learning work area. And again, any questions on any specific item that you're seeing, wonderings, thoughts?
I was wondering, what is second step in restorative classroom? It's listed in the second line, the readiness column.
So our second step is our social-emotional learning curriculum in our elementaries that the teachers follow. So that supports our students and their social-emotional well-being. Restorative practices is middle school is moving into that. It's really creating that where you restore relationships, you do restorative circles. So the middle school is just leaning into that and something that they're looking towards in the high school. So it is a framework that guides interactive conversations to restore the situation.
Okay. And then I know, you know, equity is one of those words that can be triggering for people. How is it being used in this?
Which one?
Equity in this? How is it being used in this case?
So we've talked about, I know with the board, in terms of equity. Equity is, you know, you have the resource equity, you have racial equity, you have multiple areas of equity in terms of, you know, building that base, which is that equality. That's what everyone receives. And then what are those additional supports? So if it's a resource equity, if it's financial, if it's educational equity, if it's racial equity, how are we ensuring that that takes place? So it's equity is a very broad topic. It's not just racial equity.
Is it more of a situation where we're trying to help people who need a little extra help versus forcing, you know, the same outcome for everybody? I think that's where it gets a little bit contentious for people. So I'm just curious, is it, the situation of offering more help for people who need it, or is it that we want the same outcomes for everybody?
You know, when we look at the, you know, we ultimately want, as we think about the individual success of each child, it's providing that journey for them and that learning plan for each student. So when you think of the equality, that's everyone gets the same. So we think of coherence across our elementaries. And then on top of that, Lakeview may need something different than Halverson. So that's where our resource equity comes in, or an educational equity. We may need different educational resources to support the students, depending on where they're at.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Diversity has an equal opportunity to take advantage of its circumstances or have available, as you say, assistance that's needed by virtue of their differences. It's not everybody's going to be the same.
So a good example would have been this evening when we sat in these chairs. Everyone has the same chair. I needed one that raises up a little bit higher, so that would be part of an equity piece to provide something that I need more of.
Other questions in strategy B?
So I'm not sure that I will articulate this how I want it to come out, but are there other areas under, like I see recreational drug awareness, so that seems to be a social conflict for teaching. Like we're in the business of education, but there's all these other factors that come in, right? So drug awareness is one of those factors, right? Are there other educational things like safety and security in the home? I don't know that I'm articulating it, but there's other factors than drug awareness that come out. Have we talked through that at all on what we might want to, because these are things we're currently doing. So have we had conversations about what else we could provide? Because we're here, just putting that out there, that we hear the school should be doing more as it relates to controlling the children. And I'm just saying stuff that we hear, right? Or we should be working with families more on XYZ, or we should be providing more of this. And so that's, when I see the one initiative, I think of all the other external things that are happening. And I can reword this and think about it through my head a little bit if we're not following along, but, or if I'm not articulating it right, but I just feel like that's just one of the areas that we have been charged with under education.
So two answers. So I'm gonna say yes and.
Okay.
Items that are in learning work may or may not be present initiatives. So there are items that the district is studying in learning work, and there are new items here that came up as a part of this process. So, and number two, yes and, there may be other areas that they just weren't part of or didn't come to mind as the team did this work. We want to solidify 23-24 the tightest. The other 2 years may expand and grow over time. Okay, how about strategy C, supporting staff and personal and professional growth? to add value to a healthy culture, to promote collaboration, accountability, and retention in our educational community. Questions on anything to the right?
I like the rationale for tardiness and attendance being a part of that learning work. It's not connecting with me why that would be there as a strategy.
Why that one is there instead of somewhere else? That's a hard question, so I don't remember exactly how that got there.
Yes, right now we continue to explore. It's not saying that we're not doing that, but as obviously we're not getting 100% of our students here on time, and so what do we continue to explore to do differently?
Okay.
And that's where we need to bring it back. We're not in the with the standard work, otherwise all of our students will be attending. So we need to back it way up, and then look to build out some strategies to support that.
I mean, if I were to move that tardiness, I would put it in A. That's just my take on it. But
do you think it's that accountability and collaboration piece is why we went there? That's in the C.
This is part. Yeah, this is part of that conversation. So mm-hmm. as we think about it, you know, raising the whole child and supporting them through the community, that's why we moved it and migrated it down to C.
It actually may fit better in B.
Yeah.
Fostering a learning environment that prioritizes the academics. So that
might work too. I guess I'm focusing on the fact that C seems to be around professional
yep.
development, and it just seems like that wasn't a good fit in that spot. I understand the need, but I'm not certain that's properly placed would be my feedback.
And I think Ray said this is not a finite document.
Right.
This is very fluid, so absolutely.
But it does help that they're here more often than not.
Oh, no question. Yeah.
So as we work to build out the dean model, specifically in our elementaries, it wasn't there yet. So what does that look like to support our students through the multi-tiered systems of support in level 2 or level 3? And where does the admin fit in? So it's really clarifying, exploring what does a dean model look like in our elementaries as well as our secondary. And then after we explore that, then how do we build some pieces around to increase and going back to the daily desired experience, increase that experience through the use of deans.
Would that then be the some of the other staffs, the other supportive staff? I can't think of the term jumped out of my mind where we've got teacher support with other, I can't even think of the little specialized teachers that we have helping other teachers, what we call, is that something built around that, just renaming, redoing, or?
The instructional coaches, if that's what, they're really defined in terms of their roles and responsibilities as well as the resource specialists. The deans are a little bit more abstract, so really defining that to support and serve our students. So it's, they can be used multiple ways, and I know, and Dr. Quinier has probably experienced this as superintendent and principal, a dean in one district may look different than a dean in another. So what does that look like in Albert Lea Schools?
Okay, strategy D is improving efficiency, effectiveness, and safety in district facilities, operations, and performance evaluation. Questions on any initiatives in that area?
I'm glad to see the secondary grade configuration listed, and I was just wondering, is this, it's listed in the in the column for the next school year? I believe, does that mean that that's when we would look at it, is next school year, or implement it, or what are we looking at with that?
Yeah, thank you. That would be the, you know, as we continue to explore. So it's important that we define it, and then once we define it in this, if this becomes part of our action or vision card, right, and if that becomes part of that, then after the exploration or that learning work initiative, then how do we continue to move that out? And that could move out even another year. So I don't think that's a placeholder for now, but it can definitely fluid.
By and large, anything that's in learning work doesn't come out of learning work for implementation without a decision or a choice. And most, for example, a secondary grade configuration, that'll have governance and management. So it's in study right now. We don't know what it looks like. We're thinking about it. We're exploring models. But there'll be conversations long before any decisions were made. Okay, last strategy, E, building purposeful partnerships with families to support student engagement and learning. Questions on any of those initiatives?
Yes, do we have ideas, or are we just putting down that we need to come up with ideas?
Yes.
Yes, and then if you look at the Learn right now, we're exploring. So there are different, and I believe I spoke to this last year, just where you think of parent advisory councils as well as site councils at the building. So there's multiple ways to engage with our parents and ensure that we have that input to influence voice. So what does that look like as we continue to build that out and define that? But it's not about family involvement. We need to define what is family engagement, what does that true engagement look like at our different buildings.
That we add, I'm going to go back to D if I can, because I break the rules sometimes. That's what I do. but could we, because I feel like there's learning work initiatives currently that we're doing around this area of improving efficiency and effectiveness, specifically around safety, with the work we've done at the schools, with just process and procedure kind of thing. So I would, because if you look at this without taking the deep dive, you might think, well, they're not going to do anything that's improving or making things, you know, what initiatives have started, and we've clearly done some really great things this year already. And so I would recommend to make some change there. Right, but if you're going to put secondary grade configuration as a strategy, you know, for initiative next, we had strategies that we've been, a strategy that's been identified is to make each elementary school building safer. You know, I'm not giving you the words, but just maybe the formation of why that strategy would be good to include. You see what I'm saying?
So there are two areas around, I'll call it safety and security, in this one. So implementation, work, change readiness, second bullet. We have the Raptor and visitor management system in 23-24. And then standard work, building safety management, which is, again, an umbrella initiative topic. There's lots of details underneath it, but those two do address or would address safety and security.
And we're not, the reason it's still there, it doesn't come off the board, you heard Dr. Quinier say, until it's fully implemented, if you will, or in practice. So we're still working on that. But we have made progress at all of our buildings with a welcoming and safe entrance. So that really puts us in that standard work. So we're not exploring it, we're actually doing it. We put it into action. So we're there, but we'll continue to monitor it. So that won't come off the board, if you will. That may move into next year, and we'll continue to work on even building that out further.
Sasan, are we expecting that we're going to be revisiting these plans on a yearly basis, perhaps, and deciding what's coming up and coming on, that sort of thing?
Yeah, so each year, at least once a year, the administration team will revisit this operational plan. I actually advise a more frequent engagement, and so one of the things that we'll work with the Office of the Superintendent is how do you engage with this? What is the frequency? What does it look like? Because as I mentioned, when I was doing this, I would update quarterly. So there may be things that move around. Not a lot, but once in a while. And again, right now, heavy focus on 23-24. And then as we go out, we spent less time on those 2 years. But as we move through the cycle of continuous planning, those will start to populate and grow as well.
And you will see, and once this is fully developed and adopted, then our responsibility as management is to take the plan and present to the board during study sessions. How do you know? What's your evidence? If not, then what do we need to do and take it back to the team to modify maybe some of the strategies to get to that desired metric that we have proposed? So that will be the ongoing work at the team that we will present to the board, and you will ask through an inquiry-based questions, what is it? How do you know? If not, then what are you going to do differently? That'll take place during each study session.
Which leads us into the last few pages of the packet. You're going to see a very preliminary draft vision card. And this is the tool, when completed, that the superintendent's office will report back to the board and public the progress being made on the strategic plan. So we are a bit of a ways away from this being complete, but we wanted to present this just for your awareness that this is a tool that when complete will provide the measures and metrics. So we're monitoring not just what we're doing, but what is the impact. And this is designed to work with the operational plan. So if we have a measure we're not making progress on, that might inform an initiative that has to go into the operational plan. So this will continue to evolve over time, but we put it in now just for in its draft format for you to be aware that we have this in play. The measures aren't locked down yet. We're still working on those. This is the draft from the team. All right, and then a couple of reference pages. You've seen them before of the structure of our process. So any other questions before we go back to the strategic roadmap? All right, so we're going to go back to page 2. And currently, you have a mission statement. My understanding that was recently revised or refined within a couple years ago? Okay. 16? Okay. I did not find a vision statement for the district. You do have core values. And what you see in the strategic directions are coming right from the operational plan. So those are the things that we just went through. Now, typically, if a district has nothing, then there's a process that we go through and help districts develop. And usually we would do a divide and conquer. But my proposal to the board, if acceptable, is that we work through each of these as a collective, because you already have a majority of the work completed. And we're going to spend most of our time talking about a vision statement. So the mission statement, in TeamWorks language, we define that as your core purpose. And if you look on page 5, you'll see 4 questions that we believe are what drives a mission statement. So does the mission statement should say, who do you serve? What do you specifically do for those you serve? Why do you do what you do? And how do you do what you do? So from my chair, I see that you answer all 4 questions in your mission statement, and I don't see anything in your mission that's out of alignment from the work being proposed. But we always opened it back up to the board. I had a board that said there was a word in one of their mission statement that they wanted to get out, and if that's true, your opportunity is now. But I don't see anything that needs to be changed. I think it's still, in terms of the strategic plan, it answers your 4 questions, and it's not misaligned with our work that we're presenting this evening. So. The how do you do what you do? I would say that that's really high level. How do you do what you do? In terms of a mission, yeah. So you're educating students. The vision is going to be more granular, more detailed, and I'll talk about TeamWorks nuance for vision statements. Yeah. So, any changes that board members want to be considered, or are you comfortable with your mission statement as is?
Just one thought is that I wouldn't mind seeing more focus put on excellence and being excellent, but that maybe doesn't need to go in the mission statement. That could go elsewhere.
So in our book, again, there's lots of theories and structures on mission, vision, and core values, but our belief is that the mission should become so ingrained in the organization that every adult in the organization knows it inside and out. It can be recited, it's the lens through which decisions are made, through ideas are considered. The mission is your core purpose, and everyone in the organization should know your core purpose, and actually it should be used as a lens for hiring. You wouldn't hire someone into an organization that has a different purpose than what your core purpose is. The vision, in TeamWorks' perspective, does not have to be short and succinct. We don't have to wordsmith a vision down to something that everybody can memorize, because it gets so high that it means everything to everyone. So In the vision side of things, we propose a little more granularity. And if you look at the sample roadmaps on page 3 and 4, they come from a couple other districts, you're gonna see a little bit longer statements. You're gonna see some more specificity. That actually brings it down a level from just one higher overarching statement. So the tools that we use, again, another set of questions on page 6. I'll have you flipping all over your packet. But on page 6, we just put together some questions that you might think of in terms of culture, work, and organization as you think about the vision that you want to set for the future. And as you're scanning those and the samples, what I'm going to do is take notes. You guys can just talk about key words or phrases of what you would like to see in the vision, and then we'll go from words and phrases to some sample statements. So who'd like to throw out an idea? What do you want to see in your vision statement?
Just using your cheat sheet here. Under culture, things that stood out to me under the second bullet point were mutual respect and collaboration.
Director Hoffman, I heard you reference excellence. There's a couple examples of excellence in there. Do you want to try to fold that back in as well?
Well, I'm sorry, what was the first thing you said?
I heard you say earlier about excellence. So do you want to try to fold excellence back in there? There's a couple examples of excellence and what that could look like.
That could be added to enthusiasm, passion in terms of academics.
Yes, I think this would be a good spot to include high standards and excellence and having a sense of pride. I'm just chewing on wording ideas, and I was wondering if it's possible to to look at more examples and possibly even come back to this after looking at more ideas, or if we're sitting down and doing this right now. Okay.
So there are two paths, and I've been on both of them. There are some boards where a statement emerges and we have a draft in session one. There are some that are doing what you're doing and nothing's emerging as a draft, and so we go back and generate a draft and bring that back for your consideration. The only timing difference is just when you actually take action on the roadmap. So when we get a draft that you're comfortable with, we open this all back up to your stakeholders for feedback, including your strategic roadmap, before you act on it. So if we're just generating ideas tonight and you want a draft brought back for your consideration, we can definitely do that. Well, we have that built into the structure. If you have a model that you want to consider tonight, we can do that too. It's the wish of the board.
I'd rather prefer the
Okay. You don't want a 10-person wordsmithing committee? What other things are of importance? What do you, 3, 4, 5 years from now, what are you going to be most proud of? What will Albert Lee be known for?
Absolutely, that can be improved. So yes, that's something we can look at as well.
Dave, are you okay if I flip higher attendance and less tardies to student engagement, with the assumption that if they're engaged and they're passionate about being here, then the attendance will be higher, their tardies will be down? You're okay with that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ray, I have a few things under organization. Under the first bullet. Oh, I thought other people were in work, but no.
Oh, I
would you rather that we not do that? Is that okay? So 3 words to describe that first bullet. Resources, passion, empathy. And then under the last bullet, external communities or realtors, that what would they say about our school, and that we're a strong school, growing your own, and retention.
For retention, is it both and students and staff?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any thoughts by the board around the going back to the community engagement and the partnership and what that looks like? So just a wondering to broaden.
All of them, yep, wherever you're.
Wherever you want to be.
What I'm getting out of what you're saying, it sounds like our vision would include collaborative efforts that would create learning opportunities and perhaps career opportunities for our students. It's kind of trying to pull that together in my mind. No, I mean, I agree with that. I had an electrician come to our place. He's an Albert Lee graduate, and his education was principally apprenticeship out of high school, and he's making a great living. I think at least students need to know it's an option.
Any last thoughts for vision?
I know I will come up with a lot of ideas as soon as I get home or tomorrow. is there maybe a way that we can email ideas to Ron within a certain time period to submit to you, and they're included in your thoughts?
So that was my closing remark, is that if something comes up on the drive home, yes, email them to Ron, and he will get them to me, and then we'll incorporate that into a draft. I'll capture, if anything does come up, I will capture those ideas on your draft, so you'll see everything that everybody put into the recipe, and then you'll see what came out of the oven, if so to speak. And we'll write this again. Some of these may be folded into a couple of different statements, you know, a higher level statement, but we'll try to incorporate as much as we can without getting too wordy. So if you're okay with that, get those to the superintendent by, can we say the end of the week? Would that be enough time for the board? Okay. All right, then next, we want to talk about your core values. So you have core values, and they are in alignment with the work. They definitely align with ideas that you talked about with the vision. They're in alignment with the theory of action. Our suggestion from TeamWorks is that we add a definition to your core values. And we want to put a definition, not a dictionary definition. We want to put an Albert Lee definition. So on pages 7 and 8, you're going to see list of core values that other districts have used. And as a matter of fact, you're going to see multiple definitions to the same core values. And so it ties a core value back to what it means for Albert Lee Area Schools to say, what does respect mean here? What does integrity mean here? What does compassion mean in collaboration? So we'll do the same thing that we did for the vision. We'll take these one at a time, and I'll just have you, if you have a keyword or a phrase, you can look at the examples. If you like language that's there or keywords that's there, and then we'll draft the Albert Lee definition and bring that back since we're bringing the vision back as well. So as you think about respect, what does it mean here? What does respect mean as a core value in Albert Lee?
Appropriate, but all those statements
I'm thinking also of the notion that came out of the work that was done to get here, and I think, you know, respect for our teachers too seems to be something that's that has been brought up in this process. So that's kind of where I'm going. And I do agree with Dave. I think honoring the uniqueness of myself and others captures a lot of that too.
How about integrity? What are some key words or thoughts you have around integrity? What does that mean at Albert Lea?
I think to honesty and authenticity jump out for me as key to for integrity.
I do like the idea of there's two lines that have it, of saying they'll do the right thing even when no one is looking.
Okay, how about compassion? What key words, phrases come out of?
I think those five words there capture it pretty well. I don't know what I could add to what is there.
I just wrote providing a sense or promotion of belonging.
Any other keywords or phrases on compassion? Okay, how about collaboration? Last one. How would you define collaboration for Albert Lea Schools? Okay, hard question. Is there anything missing?
Core values.
Is there a core value that is not here that we should? And there's you don't have to add any. Any other thoughts? Okay, so again, same thing. If on the drive home or tomorrow you wake up and you have different thoughts, send them to Ron and he'll share with me. And then we will be back with some drafts. The 20th, I think. So the theory or the concept underneath all of this is that if we do the work in the operational plan and we will operate under the theories of action, then we will achieve the strategies or the strategic directions. If we make movement on the strategic directions, we achieve our vision. And we do all of that under the umbrella of your mission, your core purpose, and your core values, which are drivers of your work, to bring the whole system into alignment. So even though you'll have a plan, this is meant to be a dynamic plan. It's to respond and react to what's happening, not daily, but there are times where it's nice to be able to say, we've got to push some things off. And exercising that conversation around what needs to leave the system is really important. Because at the end of the day, you are always operating with infinite needs and finite resources. And you have to build systems to do the most you can with the resources you have. So So we will bring drafts back to the board for consideration and let you wordsmith and pick apart those at that point in time. Other questions or thoughts from board members about the process, where we're going, feedback on the work the team did?
I do like the structure of 3 years. I just think that things are so dynamic something beyond three would be difficult to achieve. I think we're on the right track. And I like the language about examining after some period of time and what things can leave, the framework. So I think it's a lot of flexibility. So we can be responsive as things change over that 3 year window too. So
the mission probably won't change. The vision might.
Mm-hmm.
The vision and your desired daily experience, as we say, typically stand about 7 years. And then you test and reevaluate. For sure, then you go back and you assess your desired daily experiences. Is that still where your stakeholders want you to go? And then that drives the vision. The other thing that, as a superintendent, what I really appreciated about the operational plan is that it gave me a lens to evaluate new ideas. So that if somebody had an idea for an initiative, they could come forward and we could say, does it fit? What's our capacity to, from resources, from people to be able to put it in? Or do we have to map it out a year or two down the road? And it was really powerful as an administrative team to be able to staff and budget based on the operational plan. It just added clarity and focus to the work. Because everyone's always looking for that new thing initiative that's gonna help students. And we end up with overload of initiatives and then we don't get them done. So I know that's a biased statement, but I'm both a practitioner and a consultant of this work. So I think it's important to share. With that, I'm officially done unless you wanna extend it for another 90 minutes and talk deeper. I'm happy to stay. Well, on behalf of TeamWorks, thanks for the opportunity. I told the team this. It was a tremendous team. They worked hard. I think almost every night that we were there was a gorgeous night. And as we looked out across the football field and tried to get the work done, but they kept coming back. And just a wonderful group of people. And if that's indicative of what's happening at Albert Lea, it's a great place. So I was super excited to always come down. So thank you for the opportunity. You're not done with me yet. We've got a few more things, but I just wanted to pass that along. So with that, I'll turn it back to the board chair and superintendent.
Be here at our next meeting?
Yes.
Very good. Thank you. We look forward to that. Exercise the happiness of completing that survey, please do so as soon as possible. And the results will be tabulated by the survey machinery and made available to us.